Good evening, Ensign Cthulhu here. This is a battle I had in my Tier 8 French battleship Richelieu. This is the tech tree French battleship at that tier. My commander is 13 points, weighed towards 5 ability. And I haven't played this ship in an age, so it was a little bit terrifying taking her out. The Richelieu and her sister at Tier 9, the Jean Bart, and also the Tier 6 Dunkirk, the premium Tier 6 French battleship, all have the same gunnery layout, which is two quadruple turrets forward. Thus, you don't have to give a broadside to get all your guns on target. And as the nose armor of the Richelieu is quite decent, one acknowledged strategy is to point the front of your ship towards the enemy and just keep shooting. It can and does fall apart against ship with 18-inch guns, Georgia, Yamato, Thunder, etc. But by and large, it works if you're top tier, which I am here. So, with everything cutting in front of me on its way to get to the enemy, I'm just going to go slowly, bide my time, take my shots where I can find them. Just as I pull the trigger, the land blocking indicator appears. Typical. Everything of the enemies is funneling towards me. And I lose sight on the Normandy just as I'm about to take the shot. Smoke screens are a great thing, but if your destroyer hides in them and you've got nothing to spot for you, like an aircraft carrier or another ship, it effectively gives the enemy a smoke screen. I should probably have aimed a little further ahead of him. Oh. So he's this King George V is my team's nemesis. He is the bone that sticks in our throat throughout the entire battle. And I say that with the greatest admiration for this player. Because, you know, you're supposed to be a pain in the butt to the enemy. So, shoot the Baltimore or shoot the Huguro? Baltimore is going behind land. Take a shot at him anyway. Let's see what we get. Nothing much, right? More than I thought. About 5,000 damage. All right, Huguro here has run aground. And now he has to back his way out of his predicament. So aim just a little bit towards the rear of him. Shells out. $7,000 damage. Huguro is a Miyoko clone from the ARP collaboration and does not have a heal. Okay, now watch the smokestacks. The smoke is coming up to the vertical and he's going to start going forward. I should have aimed a little further forward, I think, ideally. But he takes a while to get moving. 2380, and then the North Carolina blaps him. So up until now, I've done a lot of backing up. Hello, Arizona. Pleased to meet you. Arizona is a near sister to the New Mexico, with some gunnery tweaks and premium status. 7,500 off him. So everything in my New Mexico battle sort of applies to the Colorado, so applies to the Arizona, sorry, as well. Terribly slow and giving broadside to enemy battleships with slightly higher caliber guns. Richelieu's got 15 inches. It's not a good idea. Another 4,000 off him. He's not learning his lesson, though. I mean, he's probably going to kill this North Carolina, who, yep, he kills the North Carolina, who stuck his neck right in the noose, as I have done all too often. Citadel hit for nearly 15,000. That's going to hurt, and it's going to be hard to heal back. You generally don't, when you push the heal button on a battleship, you don't get much of that AP Citadel damage back. So, I've backed up for long enough. Time to engage speed boost and head into the fight. I've done 43,000 damage so far. The enemy team has paid very dearly for sticking its neck in this noose. And the Arizona is about to repeat all his mistakes in the other direction. There's 10,000 damage in partial and full penetrations. Someone sets me on fire. I'm just going to let it burn. More shots out on the Arizona. Another 3,600 off him. He seems to have stopped almost dead in the water for some reason. That's okay. I won't look a gift horse in the mouth. 9,000 damage. And I call target on him for someone to finish him off. Is that King George V spitting fire at me? He's almost stationary, and ...4,000 damage and takes off a gun turret for a while. If I push in at this stage, I risk getting focused down by, like, the North Carolina did. Oh, three fires. I'm putting that out. I just took a little too short a lead here. Another 4,000 damage. Another fire. A little more lead this time. I think they're focusing on me at this point. I can't seem to do more than $4,000 chip damage. A little bit here, a little bit here, there, it does add up. Alright, hello Arizona. You're still alive. $6,600 health. He won't be if these torpedoes reach him, though. Yep, goodbye. Okay. Now Baltimore sinks the enemy Normandy. We are ahead on points. We are even on caps. It's time to punch the speed boost and go take decap. Their carrier is sticking its neck out somewhat dangerously. Hello, Baltimore. Pleased to meet you. Should have fired a little further forward. Goodbye, Mr. Baltimore. Okay, I think I keep on underestimating this guy's speed. Although I do about 5,000 damage to him. Okay, now I can see where this enemy battleship is hiding out, just to the north of that little crevice in the rocks on the east side of D. So I decide I'm going to go chase after him. If he's going to camp out there, I'm either going to force him to move or kill him. In the meantime, I'm going to turn my guns back towards the Weser here. Shots out. Goodbye, Weser. There goes their carrier. Okay, and no sooner do I go around this side of the rock than the North Carolina is seen coming through the gap. So it was a good idea at the time, but it would be pointless to try and ring around the rosy, so I'm just going to completely reverse my course as quickly as I can, which isn't very quickly because battleships turn like drunken snails. But I'm going to turn around and do everything I can to help my colleagues. Now, that New Mexico is only Tier 6 against the North Carolina's Tier 8, but if the North Carolina comes out broadside in front of him, and he's going to have to, because of the way that channel's arranged, the New Mex has a fighting shot to get some heavy broadside hits, and is bow-on, so he will take less damage from the North Carolina. He's also got the Colorado to help him, and the Colorado's guns are quite capable of doing bad things to the North Carolina if he tries to turn north and avoid the New Mex. He's got to give his broadside to somebody. And he gives it to me for 14,000 damage. Not one citadel like earlier, but several individual heavy hits. And over-penetration does 10% of the shell's total potential damage. A full penetration does 33%, and a citadel hit does the full 100%. Okay, only bounces and shatters there. That's what good angling can do, or sometimes good luck. Okay, we're well ahead on ships, but they're ahead on caps, and we're not that too far ahead on points. So I would really like to get this battleship down, thank you. Nice big citadel hit there. 17,000 damage. This guy's not long for the world. Colorado's shells are just as good as his. Get some in chat. Yeah. Oh, hello, King George V. My nemesis has returned. One other thing I'm cognizant of is that enemy destroyer coming up on my left. The one advantage I've got here is that Vastra's torpedoes do not hit very hard. And if he gets me with one or two, it's not instant death. In fact, he could get me with all six and I might still survive, but hey, you know. I'm not just going to be his punching bag. Take the shot. It would have been better to have high explosive loaded here, but I didn't have time to reload it. And I'm cognizant of having to take on the battleship as well. So here I'm turning away to the right to keep away from the Vastaras' torpedoes and to let me take this cap. Or to let me help my colleague take this cap. Okay, that's done. So I'm going to point my guns in the direction that I last saw the destroyer. There go his torpedoes behind me. And I'm really lucky that this King George V is deciding to use nothing but high explosive just about. Because if he'd hit me full broadside with AP, I might have suffered very badly. Despite the fact that they've only got two ships to our six, they are nearly even on points. And they have fought well. If a few more of my teammates had died stupidly, they might actually have a lead in this fight. There you go. Oh! Here are the Vastaras' torpedoes. Can I dodge between? By the grace of God, yes. I meant to fire one salvo at his middle and another at his nose, but I accidentally ended up firing both turrets at once. So we are now ahead on caps, ahead on ships, ahead on points. Now Colorado is left far, far behind, but it also keeps him safe from inadvertent, stupid death. So, really, there's nothing more to do at this point except... there we go. Wait for the end. Hope you enjoyed that, and good night.